September, at one point in September, the camera's coming in, bro.
Lights,
camera,
action.
Action.
Welcome to my life. This is my crib. So let me show you around. This is my corner. Thank you for visiting my crib. Okay. That was it.
That's it?
That was it. Well, I gotta want to show my closet because, you know, I'll be a weird flex. I'm not ready for that. Because, well, you know, you're
here doing the closet.
No, but you're here preaching that we're humble. We're just trying to thrive and struggle. And okay, if I show them that, you know, the lowest budgeted, like, clothing wear I got is Louis Vuitton, uh-huh, then they're not going to buy into the hustle anymore. And now I'm going to look like Bow Wow trying to flaunt on my private jet.
But except Bow Wow doesn't really have it, though.
No, but
except be the opposite of Bow Wow.
Yeah, but now,
that's what you're trying to say.
But now I'm trying to take hold of a struggle I don't have. And so I lose credibility.
Because
you know that people always trying to, like, pretend like they hustle and they work hard and they're struggling. I live in the suburbs.
Yeah. I get. So what you're saying is you're trying to take the opportunity to, like, pretend like you're struggling. You know what I'm saying?
Because, you know, that way when they find out, like, dang, Chris is driving a Ferrari, they didn't think it was because I hustled. They didn't because I relied on my daddy's money.
That makes some sense. I get
some street respect. Word.
So you're defrauding the audience of I'm Down.
No, I'm not defrauding. I am make-believing. I am increasing imagination.
Okay. So defrauding the audience of I'm Down.
Because I'm not charging you money to believe my truth.
Okay, that's a good point.
I always told you
that's
that.
That's a good point.
I'm not a liar. I'm a storyteller.
Okay.
Right? I just have a very creative imagination. And I just invite you into my world. It's like what Pixar does. We know Mr. Incredible doesn't exist. It's what Disney makes money of. We know all the superheroes don't exist, but ask me how many movies I've seen in the movie theater.
A bunch, huh?
Way too many.
Gotcha,
if I start racking up a bunch of money waste on tickets,
that makes sense.
But
that
why? Because people want something or someone to believe in.
Okay.
Because guess what? Most people are stuck in misery.
Yeah.
And so they need something to pull them out of misery. For some people, it's drugs. For some people, it's alcohol. For some people, it's sex. For some people, it's this. But we all are trying to get something that will give us just enough to help us forget something else.
Yeah. Okay, so that's like, that's a good point right there to jump into this one. So that's almost like, I guess like the opposite of that would be like you said, people are trying to just get, like, just enough to get past, right, to get by. But then that also kind of tells you why people be hating on
the
people that have, like, the maximum confidence and the maximum, like, energy, you know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, that shit ain't really matching me. Why the fuck do you have that? So let me find some shit to hate on, right?
Yeah, of course. But look, there's nothing more frustrating to normal people than someone who's actually confident.
Yeah.
Not someone who plays it, but someone who is actually confident.
Yeah.
There's nothing more attractive and frustrating.
Yeah.
Because, like, there's a part of you that if you're honest with yourself, you're gonna be like, damn, I wish I was like that.
Yeah.
But then there's that part of you that's like, yo, I can't let them see my weakness. So, you know, you just be acting, just swear. You swear all that.
Yeah.
Because, you know, because that person's not looking at anybody else for approval.
Okay, so you think the people that constantly saying, oh, he just swears he's all that. He swears. You think that those people are, you're bringing out insecurity in those people. That's what you mean.
Yeah, you're reflecting your weaknesses, right? Because if that person's truly confident, trust me, bro, they ain't worried about what you're thinking.
Yeah.
And that person, if you say, like, oh, that person swears all that. If you don't know them, your opinion, to someone who's confident, your opinion does not matter.
Yeah.
If you know them and you are someone who's close to them, I guarantee you, if they tell them, yo, I think you swear.
Yeah.
That might be like, yo, let me check myself. Because they're confident.
Yeah.
So they're confident enough to also check themselves.
Yeah.
Because I think that's part of being confident. Part of being confident is understanding, you know, I'm cool with who I am, but I'm also cool with the dark parts of me enough to examine within myself and not be afraid of what might come out.
Yeah.
Because confident people are vulnerable people. They're able to speak on weaknesses. Mm-hmm. Just as they're able to show strengths.
Yeah.
You know, they know what they're good at. They know what they suck at.
Yeah.
And they're okay in that space in between.
Yeah. And you know, so okay. So I had to backtrack, right? Because so you're basically like giving an example of what a confident person would be, right? So what is then the difference between, at least in your point of view, the difference between confident and that point of arrogance or that point of like, or what you would call, for lack of better words, what I would call like a dickhead or something,
a cockiness,
like that,
right?
Or a douchebag or something like that.
There's this proverb that says, pride comes before the fall.
Okay.
That, for me, is the border between confidence and cockiness.
Which is a very thin.
And let's be honest, when you're walking in confidence, there's a chance that you might cross that border, but you have to have the self-awareness to notice, yo, I'm going overboard. Why? Because when I mean confidence, I mean someone who's comfortable in their own skin. I don't always talk about being satisfied or being complacent. I don't believe in complacency. I think complacency can kill you.
Yeah.
I think being confident, being comfortable is different than being complacent, right?
Yeah.
So when I say confident, I mean someone who's okay understanding I have certain weaknesses and I have certain strengths. But neither this nor that makes me any less or any more.
Yeah.
I am who I am and I'm cool with that. Oh. Right? Now, cockiness is that point when you focus so much on your strength, it leads you to being blind to the fact that your strength is actually becoming your weakness that's leading you to a demise. That's why pride comes before the fall. The moment I think I don't need anybody else, I got all I need, I got all I want, I got everything, I'm good, I don't need anything. At that point, we get this God complex, whether we speak it out or not, right? Where I think that leads us to falling because we lost our track.
Okay, so basically, let's say like visually, confidence will be cockiness and silence.
Yeah, like there's a certain when we talk about athletes, right? You know, you hear the conversation athletes all the time. The best athletes say, "I might not say it, but I was thinking that I am the best person here. Nobody can cover me."
Yeah.
Right? So there's a certain like cockiness you need to be the best at your craft.
Yeah, or you should think that.
Or you should think that to drive you. Like that mentality should drive you. Like, I'm gonna be the best because nobody here can stop me, right?
Yeah.
But there also has to be a humility to you that says, but this person's really good at that. Maybe I could learn from them.
Like recognize.
Yeah. Maybe I can. That is confidence. Yeah. Why? Because I can come to you and be like, yo, how did you do that? That was amazing.
Yeah.
With that feeling that because you're good at that, makes me bad at that.
Yeah.
But most people, including ourselves, we won't confide or seek for wisdom or advice from somebody else because we equal that to weakness.
Yeah.
Which is not. It means that that person is good at something and I can learn from them and also craft and maybe even be a better person and be comfortable that now I can be more versatile, more well-rounded.
Yeah. So that's also like a man thing.
Yeah, for sure. Time, right? Yeah, yeah. Because I think women are like, you know, I always find it funny, but girls always talk among themselves and they compliment each other randomly.
Like
you're walking in the street and I've seen it all the time. Like people, you see it too.
Yeah.
Walking the street. I love your dress.
Mm-hmm.
To somebody you've never seen in your life.
Yeah, yeah.
And another person will be like, thank you, I love your hair. And it's such an innate, natural thing.
Yeah.
But I've never, like, I compliment you because you're not cool.
Mm-hmm.
But I've never done it. And I don't think I've done it. But, you know, we even had this conversation. I did it yesterday.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But most dudes don't do that.
Or not normally.
Yeah, most dudes don't go like, yo, you're fresh.
Yeah.
Or yo, you're tight. Or yo, you're amazing.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of like a masculine thing. Like
an alpha thing.
Like,
a,
yo,
like an alpha
I'm
thing.
Giving way to his authority over mine.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
yeah. It's like I think that's definitely like a guy's weakness.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like this alpha thing where it's like, nah, like
I'm
you
the,
think
I'm
you're,
it. Yeah,
yeah
I'm
like,
it.
I'm the alpha male. I can't give you more power. You know,
because then you're
going to
be better than me.
Yeah, exactly. So, and that's insecurity in the man.
All
yeah, because
the
you're
all
you're
the
over here thinking like, damn, I'm gonna be smaller if I give you a compliment or I try to lift
mm-hmm.
you up. You get me? So like, cause nobody's gonna lift me up.
Yeah, exactly. So if I lift you up, then I'm pushing myself down.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, then again though, it's all. I think that guys are always like less friendlier than girls are too. Though, you get
no,
me?
No, no. But like, let's be honest. You know,
okay,
we
I
also
mean,
suck at complimenting and giving and taking compliments too. As
well,
guys,
some people.
As guys.
Well, as guys, I think it depends
what,
on the type
what
of guy.
What would be a like for example, like yesterday, I'll give you guys a real life example. Yesterday, I may have gone a little overboard.
Right.
Well, in this case, it won't be yesterday. It'll be whatever, whenever.
Yeah, yeah.
But we were having brunch, right? And there was this server that was like great. Like I thought, like you know, the way he was serving, the way he smiled, the way it was like he made you feel like he was enjoying that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which obviously I don't think any server enjoys serving.
Right.
But that vibe, that energy, that excellence, right, or spirit in him, was like, I was like, yo, I really like how you're serving.
Yeah.
I really like your attitude. I really like your smile, right? Because the whole time, dude brought me ketchup, dude brought me this, dude brought me that, and he did not stop smiling once. Like,
yeah.
He literally looked like he was enjoying serving us.
Yeah.
And it's a spirit that is not common in people, right?
Yeah.
And so I commented on that, right, and he was like, oh, thank you, no, whatever, cool. But we laughed at that because it's like, yo, you shouldn't tell another dude you have a great smile.
Yeah, yeah. It was definitely weird.
Weird, but exactly. Weird. But I've heard girls say, you have beautiful eyes, you have beautiful smile to each other. Random girls,
yeah.
They don't meet.
Yeah,
so
I
think as guys,
toxic masculinity,
we don't want to be able to say, yo, that's a good looking dude. Or, damn,
yeah.
That guy is great. That guy is a leader. That guy is strong. Because
yeah.
the compliments guys give are like oh, that's cool. You really look fresh. You look dope.
Yeah.
Those are very, like, very distant,
yeah,
from far compliments.
Yeah. They're not, like,
we can't be close, like you're never gonna go, like, yo, you have a gray beard. Like, it's gonna be weird.
It gets weird. It depends. I think if you're, like, in that, within, like, that community.
No, but if you're, like,
you
friends,
might,
all right, cool. But I'm talking about, like, in general.
Like, a randomly, yeah.
Because generality is what exposes you.
Yeah.
Because in intimacy, you can be more honest. Let's be honest. Like, I can tell you something right here that I would feel as awkward saying to the other person I don't meet.
Yeah.
Right? But I think that is where we suck as guys.
Well, I mean, it again, though, I think it's always, like, that play that I think that we're coming into a new age of, like, men being more aware of, like, yo, maybe I should talk about my emotions. Maybe I should give more confidence. Yeah, but we're just getting to that now. Yeah, I mean, I think that maybe, like, in the next, like, 50 years, you get me? Like, or
we'll see an adjustment.
Like, you see a huge adjustment, you get me? Into, like, where male and male are just more, you get me? Like, I guess it's empathetic, I guess you could say, or, like, you know, really just more
open
in a way, you get me? Like, we're just in regards to, like, giving out compliments and talking about their emotions and their feelings, because it's, again, most of us really are on that kind of tip, you get me?
Yeah.
Because I think, like, even now, you know, you're seeing, like, a surge of, like, emotional guys, you get me?
Yeah.
Or like the reaction of men are coming emotional. Like, for me, I give the reaction all the time when I hear, like, oh, I heard somebody say that, oh, you think you're all that. I give that emotion because I'm not walking around thinking I'm all that. I'm just walking around
minding my own business.
Yeah, like a regular person. But just some people, I guess, I don't know, the way I walk, the way I look or whatever, might be like, oh, this motherfucker thinks
swears
shit. But I'm like, oh, motherfucker, I don't swear shit. I'm just walking to my house. I don't know what to tell you. Like, I'm just, I don't know.
I got Dickies on.
Right. So in my head, I will get like, hold the fuck on. But then, you know, you kind of just start to realize, like, well, you know, the people that are generally maybe talking like that or something like that is probably because they feel some type of way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's within them. So, again, it's almost something that you kind of have to understand. Like, yo, a lot of people, when they get angry out of nowhere, they start talking out of nowhere and stuff like that, you gotta almost have to, like, be more understanding than to get angry at them.
Of course.
Because it's like they're probably going through something.
But it's hard, bro.
Right, it for sure it is. Like, but that's where, like, a lot of self-awareness comes from, because that's the difference between, oh, I feel bad for this person talking reckless, and, oh, I'm going to fight with this person talking reckless. You get me? Because that's really going to be, like, that's going to define where you're at. Because realistically, if somebody says, oh, Chris, oh, you swear you're all that, da da da, your initial reaction might be like, yo, like, tying up, you know.
Actually, no.
My
initial reaction is, I am glad that you're aware that I'm the greatest of all time.
Okay,
Thank you. Gotcha.
So you're going to kill them with kindness, in other words. That's what you're trying to, in other words, you're fighting, but you're just picking a style of fighting.
Yeah.
You are fighting, though, nonetheless.
Yeah,
because that's what I'm trying to get at. So, like, either you're going to fight, or you're going to be like, I understand, like, you're pathetic.
Yeah.
I get it. Like, your life is...
First of all, if you told me that, right there, I am jumping off this ledge head first.
You didn't kill yourself? Fuck it.
Yeah, I don't understand. You're pathetic. Oh.
You wouldn't say that, but in your head, you're thinking, like, damn, like, you must be going through something.
Listen, boy.
Yeah, like, you might be like, yo, you're going through something that's going to make you feel like you could tell me this. You know what I'm saying? Because what makes you think you could tell me this? Well, first of all, nobody's really ever told me that, though, like on a serious note, like, some random person, like, oh, you swear you're on that. Nobody's ever told me that, right? It's always, like, a he said, she said.
Well, situation. I told you, like, one time, like, people close, like, real close to me told me, yo, I want you to know nobody likes you. That hurt my feelings.
Let's talk about that.
Wait, all right.
So first of all, how did that even get to
be? Because
let's talk about that.
Honestly, I was like, we were in a conversation how adults tend to like me, because I, like, overall, I like to think I'm a very respectful person, right? Like, I joke around with adults, and I mess around a lot. Like, I mess around more than kids mess around with their parents and adults, because they don't have that comfort. I do. I've been bugging people all the time, right? So I was like, you know, people love me, and then, you know, I'm not gonna say names, told me that nobody likes me. And I was like, you know, I thought it was just being haters.
Wait. So when you heard that, your first thing was,
yeah, like,
please.
Yeah, because I'm like, yo,
please.
Everybody likes me.
Please.
I am a likable guy. Like,
okay.
This wasn't a cocky thing. I really did think I was likable.
Yeah, okay. So like, you really, in your mind, you're like, yo, like, people like me. Like,
yeah,
generally
like
me.
People,
I feel like you have no beef with nobody.
I literally think I'm an easygoing guy.
Yeah.
I want everybody to have a good time.
Yeah.
You know, I always want to make people laugh. Like,
yeah.
I'm like, yo, I think I'm likable.
Yeah.
I think people like me. And then, you know, they confirm with somebody else who hangs out with me a lot. Nobody likes you. Especially nobody your age. And I was like, shit.
So it was a surprise to
you. And at that point, I was like, well, but why? Like, you know, at that point, they're hurting my feelings.
Yeah.
I was like, but why? Because they think you swear. You're always commanding conversations. You're always being loud. You're always being the center of attention.
Mm-hmm.
which to me was funny because I always thought I was making people laugh. From the outside in, is I want people to look at me. Yeah. From the inside out, I wanted people to have a good time.
Gotcha.
And
gotcha.
So, and so that day, I was like,
okay, so you felt like in situations a lot of people weren't generally having a good time, so you felt the need to like facilitate that.
Like, or like sometimes I'm really comfortable being dumb. Like I like being dumb. Yeah. Like I go to the parks and I just run around like an idiot or whatever.
Yeah.
Once there's an allegation that I almost burned down a P of Chance. There's an allegation there. But I, you know,
hey, hold on. Let's not go past that.
So no, that's not the details.
Okay. Another time.
But I always tell people, look, you're not gonna remember it in any time the coming. You're gonna remember it the funny, the awkward, the weird, the dumb. Yeah. So to this day, it was somebody's birthday. We didn't even talk about their birthday. We talk about the time Chris almost burned out P of Chance.
Okay, so that was the highlight of that moment.
So to me, it's like, I gave you guys a memory. We all enjoyed it together.
Yeah.
But somebody could have said, no, Chris, you just wanted attention.
Oh.
And so finding out that I'm not likable was hurtful to me because I always thought people liked me.
Okay, hold up. So you are clear, though, that for your intentions, right, your initial intentions, just, I want people to have a good time.
All the time.
Other people's reason for you acting the way you act is, this guy just wants to be the center of attention.
Yeah. He wants to be seen. He wants to be everything. Yeah. He thinks he's it because he thinks that every girl wants, blah, blah, blah. And I've heard it all across the line. Yeah, I think every girl wants him. He thinks every dude wants to be like him or whatever. Right. He thinks he's the alpha male. I've heard all kinds of conversations. Yeah. And to me,
do you think you're an alpha male?
I think I'm loud and maybe I'm commanding.
Well, do you think you're an alpha male, though?
Maybe. I don't know.
Again, I don't really believe in that generally. I know you don't believe in that, but throughout the... What's that? The signs? The sun?
The
zodiac
or whatever?
That shit. There you go. Right? You're a Leo. So, Leo is supposed to be, like, commanding, stubborn. You know, a lot of those shits, even though I generally don't believe in it, but it's kind of accurate, right? To some point. Technically, a Leo isn't... A lion, regardless, is supposed to be, like, an alpha, regardless.
Now.
Would you consider yourself an alpha, though?
I don't know. Like...
Nobody's ever told them, you're like an alpha male.
No, you always tell me that I'm very dismissive to people.
Well, sometimes, for sure.
You're always like, no.
But I think that just comes from you and your power of knowing. I think that's your superpower. Your superpower is knowing.
Yeah,
you know?
But I guess if I'm dismissive, then maybe it's because I think my opinion is more important than yours.
Maybe.
Because, like, that's why I always think, I'm like, damn, Chris, you need something to shut up. You're making people feel like you don't value their opinions. Right? So, it's funny how, like, from the outside, you can look at somebody and say, like, that guy's super cocky. And from the inside, you have this insecurity where you feel like you're not being good enough for people.
Okay.
And so, I think that's where I'm in that space.
So, you're trying to find a balance.
I'm trying to find a balance. Like, I am very confident in me.
Yeah.
Like, I think I know where I'm good at. I think I know where I suck at.
Yeah.
Right? And so, I'm confident in the fact that I can be an idiot.
Yeah.
So, when people question my intelligence, I can still prove to you that I'm smart enough.
Right.
Right? So, I can be, like, funny. And not lose credibility, right?
That's right.
But there's times where I feel like maybe I overdid it to one point or to the other. Mm-hmm. Like I was so dumb that maybe I hurt somebody, or I was so intellectually imposing, quote unquote, right? That I could have offended somebody, dismissed or disregarded them.
Well, okay, but there's a thing. So, like, if you kind of like look into it, though, right? Like the whole aspect of like being dismissive, though, is this: is really just the word in the middle. So, like, for example, I could be like, I actually really like those shoes. You might be like, nah. Those joints ain't for me, you get me? And like somebody could have been like, I get what you're saying, but those joints ain't for me, you get me? That's the way you convert the conversation.
Right.
But the thing is, it's not necessarily like, you're trying to be like, no, like your opinion sucks, my opinion is better. It's not necessarily interjected like that, you get me? Because that's what I'm saying, it really just depends on what the context of the conversation
is. Of course, but the thing is, a lot of times people can't get what you mean, they get what you said.
Of course.
So,
humans, regardless, you gotta read between the lines every time.
Yeah, but most people don't do that. Let's be honest. Most people are not conscious
enough. Girls are just good enough to do that.
Yeah,
usually.
But dudes are not conscious. Like, if I say, nah, you're gonna be like, not you specifically, like, dude, you'll be like, yo, what's up with this homie?
Yeah.
What's up with this guy?
Okay. All right. No, I guess no.
I guess he thinks he knows it all.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. You
know?
I get what you're saying.
So, I think that the dynamic of cockiness and confidence is such a hard one because I think we bounce between spaces. And most people, the saddest thing, most people don't even bounce between those two spaces. They bounce between insecure and security in the wrong things.
Yeah. Well, like ego, though.
Yeah.
I mean, let's go with ego. I think that just in that whole realm, it's really just, it's just a lot of ego that plays in. So like, it, and again, it's really like a male driven thing, because I mean, sure, there's girls that have ego, but it's not like, you know, I don't know, like, it's not very, it's not too likely, you get me? Like, like for girls to be like overpowered with like, oh no, nah, I'm the boss and like that, it's kind of like, you know, it's more likely rare, you get me? Like, if you really see like in like workspaces or whatever, if you work with girls, like me personally, like, if I had to choose who I had to work with, I'd rather work with the world. Like,
for
with
real?
Women. Yeah, I'd rather work with women than work with men. And I'm going to tell you why. So women have this eye for detail all the time. You get me? So like some of that, but like me currently, like, I work with all girls. Like literally, like the majority of the people I work with are females. So it's, they catch things that I might not really catch. You get me? Because I'm not really trying to pay attention to certain things, right? When in other words, women can. You get me? And they don't have this ego thing. So for example, like let's say you're the boss, right? And you're gonna go call somebody's attention. Let's say you're the boss and you call my attention, right? You call my attention in a kind of way. It's always gonna be
some friction.
Mm-hmm. Because it's always that ego. It's always like you're trying to be above me.
To impose your authority.
Exactly. And because you're my boss, I can't really say shit to you unless I wanna lose my job, right? In a sense, or I wanna have a bad rapport with you. So it's almost like, fuck, I gotta do it. But I'm always gonna have that like negative, like, yo, fuck this guy.
Yeah, this,
like,
guy swears.
Yeah, this guy swears he's gonna come. But as with the girl, you might go up to a girl, tell her something, and she might, like, maybe, you know, you said it a harsh way. She might feel some type of way about it, yummy, because, like, the emotion hit. But, you know, like, you kind of squash that later on, yummy. You might squash that shit later on regardless. Like, she might be understanding. You might go, you will most likely, as especially as a guy or
apologize.
A girl, go back and say, hey, look, I'm sorry if I lost my. Whatever, you don't really want to do that too much with a guy, because you're not, you know, you're not used to doing that
shit.
Yeah,
it's like exhibiting weakness.
Exactly. Quote unquote. So that's what I'm saying. So like, it really just, it, I'm telling you, the ego drives a man, and it's like, the ego is like one of like the most dangerous things about a man regardless. Like, your ego will keep you from not apologizing when you should apologize. Your ego will keep you from not admitting you're right when you know
or
you're
forgiving.
Wrong. Or exactly. Like, it's always going to be like your ego.
Yeah.
So that's why in that realm is always going to be hard, because it's like, yo, a man, like, challenge. You get me? Within that.
You got a puff your chest.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, look, ego will make you cocky.
Yeah, all the time.
I mean, like, think about it like this. Like, it comes like natural too, but like, let's say like you, right? Growing up, you always were told like, oh man, you're so pretty, you're so handsome, whatever, right? Realistically speaking, if it's not within you to like humble yourself, that could drive your ego up and be like,
I'm the shit, I get all the girls,
fuck these guys. And now the minute a guy comes in and he's not getting all the girls' attention, that's when you start feeling threatened.
Yeah, you're like, damn.
What the fuck? Fuck this guy.
And then you start questioning your identity. Like,
exactly.
Because your identity was based on meaningless vanity.
Exactly. And it's all because your ego was just
boosted.
So you're right. It's true what you're saying, though. Like, you have to like be like, you should feel like you're the best, but you should also be humble enough to be self-aware
that there can be somebody better.
Exactly. Like, so it's always going to keep that in check.
I remember like a while back somebody told me, you don't always be a better writer. You will always be a better speaker. You will always be a better leader. A better blah 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 blah. That doesn't mean you're not good.
Yeah.
And that has driven me. And I was young. Has driven me, because I thought that if I wasn't the best, I was not good enough. Mm. And so it starts messing with you when you find talented people.
Yeah.
Because then you're like, dang, I'm not that. So I must suck.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, no, you're good, and it's okay that they're better. Yeah. But I guarantee you, some things you're gonna be better at, or just some. You know, rapport or whatever you got, some skill you got that they don't got.
Yeah.
Right? And I think that is where we gotta be humble and self-aware. Like, self-awareness is so necessary in every space.
Yeah.
Like, in mental and the physical and the emotional, you need self-awareness, right? And to just say, I'm okay. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna be alright.
Yeah, I'm gonna be good. Yeah.
I'm gonna be good. This ain't gonna kill me. This ain't gonna define me. I can get past this.
Yeah.
If somebody becomes better, they're not a threat. They're a teacher.
Yeah. Facts.
I can learn.
Facts. So, okay, so to make a quick transition, right? So yesterday we did record the first part of the show, but it got cut off, unfortunately, right?
Uh-huh.
So we're on the side of you turning 25, very soon.
Oh.
You said quarter century. Maybe don't say everything you said, but I kind of recap. I got to close this whole thing off with how you're going into your 25s, like your mentality. What you've experienced so far, you know, kind of resume to make it packed
gotcha,
up.
Gotcha. So, you know, for those of you know me close, like I was telling you, you know, I used to think that at 25 I'd be married. Mm-hmm. I was a guy with a plan, right? I thought, you know, I was going to do school, get a degree, check. I was going to thrive, check. just gonna get a job, good job, half check. You know, like, I was gonna be married at 25, maybe buy a house like, 2 years later, and then at 28 have a kid or something on those lines. No. Now I'm 25, and I don't think I'm gonna get married anytime soon. Not because it's because I think it's not the right time, right? And I think that as I get older, I'm realizing that people are more important than possessions. To love God, to eat good food, and to drink good wine or good juice, if you like juice or water, whatever you hydrate with, right? That's the bottom line. Like, we try to make life too complicated, and we get consumed in the vanities and the stuff and the materialism and the ego and the wanting to be this and wanting to be that, that we lose our life because we start living for other people. You know, live for, not you, but live for a meaningful thing. Live for a passionate thing. Live for that thing that will drive you to wake up every morning, right? And enjoy the small things in life. You know, have a good pizza. Have a good glass of wine. Or have good chocolate. Have a good ice cream. I'm not saying you have to overdo it because everything in moderation, right? But just learn to be satisfied with the small victories. Because I don't know if I'm going to make it to 75, 100 or whatever. But I hope that when I look at 50, I can look back and say, you know what? I'm getting better. Like, the best Chris has yet to be lived.
Yeah.
My best day has yet to be lived. My best moment has yet to be experienced. Uh-huh. You know? And I used to hate birthdays. I didn't want attention. I didn't want nothing. But as I'm getting older, I'm looking at birthdays like milestones and memories rather than meaningless celebrations. So I'm excited, you know, like I was telling you, like, yo, I want to have a dinner because obviously I want to have a dinner with people that I want to be able to say, like, yo, the next 25 years that God gives me, I want you to be part of this life, right? Because I want to celebrate the people around me. 25 means I have 25 years of blessing, 25 years of growth, 25 years of transitions, of development, of maturity, hopefully, of, you know, just being the best version of me yet. But I don't think this is where it ends. And I think that is what is teaching me, you know, just to value this quarter century. Is like, if I get 3 more quarters, then the 4th quarter Chris will be the best one.
Yeah.
And up to that point, let's just keep growing. That's how I see it.
Dope. All right, guys. So there you have it. Once again, if you thought that this episode and this podcast was entertaining, if you thought it was inspiring, if you thought it was excellent, if you thought it was dumb, stupid, provocative, whatever your thoughts were, leave your comments down below, share, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you guys for tuning in. Once again, this is Down. Until next time.
We'll be live streaming from 51. Pull up.